Hello, welcome to Waypoint Survival. Today, I want to show you a sleeping trick that no one knows. Stay tuned. So many times when we're out backpacking and hiking, practicing our survival skills, sleeping in a tent or a tarp shelter or a hammock, after a long day of hiking and climbing and carrying a heavy load on your back or around your shoulder, you will often have a hard time sleeping. Now, I learned this trick from my brother-in-law, and so obviously the title is a bit tongue-in-cheek. It is purposely hyperbole. There are people that know about this. However, it's a really clever trick, and I think it's really useful for those of us who spend our time in the outdoors. So one of the things that I like to have with me in my kit, and it doesn't take up a lot of room, is I like to have some soap. And this is just an Altoids tin with some white duct tape on it, and I wrote on it with a Sharpie. Inside is a simple burlap bag. And this burlap bag just has a little bit of a drawstring made from some bank line, so I can keep it closed. But it has just a small bar of soap that came from a motel. This is a new bar of soap. I have a lot of these. I try to collect them whenever I travel. And it's important that this bag can breathe. After I use it, whether it's to wash myself or anything else like that, to wash up my clothes, underwear and socks and things like that, I can hang this from a limb out in the sun and it will go ahead and dry, so I don't have to put it away damp inside of my tin. But it has another very important use. After a long day of hiking and backpacking and walking around, some people suffer from restless leg syndrome or even muscle cramps at night. Now, obviously, you can use mustard for that. That will help with leg cramps, and that's a very useful homeopathic remedy. But this right here works really, really well. Now, my brother-in-law tells me, and he talked to his doctor about it, and the doctor said it's actually a thing. There has been research done on it, and they're not exactly sure why it works, but there are a lot of people who say that this is incredibly effective, both for restless leg syndrome and for cramps. And it needs to be next to your feet when you sleep at night. So hence the little bag that the air can get through. Now, some people say you need to use lavender. Other people say it has to be a specific kind of soap, like Dove soap. But from what I understand, any kind of soap will actually work. And what it seems to do is it helps your body release magnesium into your bloodstream. And that, of course, will help relieve the cramping and also ease the restless leg syndrome, so you can actually get a good night's rest. So after we have taken off our shoes, got ready for bed, of course I'm still wearing my clothes, this is just for demonstration purposes, we just unzip our sleeping bag, take this little bag. Of course, you want to make sure it's dry. You don't want to get soap all over your sleeping bag, and that's why it's important to have it in a bag like this. Of course, a cloth bag will work. It doesn't have to be a burlap bag. We just take this and you just throw it down in the bottom of your sleeping bag, where it can be right next to your feet, and you go to sleep. My brother-in-law says that his daughter, my niece, actually washed the bedclothes some time ago, and without realizing it, the bar of soap that he keeps at the foot of his bed fell down on the floor. And for several nights, he was having problems with restless leg syndrome. And finally, he asked his daughter what she had done, and she said, "Yeah, I washed the bed sheets." And so he dug around the bottom of the bed and found the bar of soap and put it back, and can sleep well again at night. So if you have problems when you're out in the backcountry with restless leg syndrome or cramps from a lot of walking and hiking, of course, drink some water. Could be dehydration. That's another cause. But also, try the bar of soap. I think you just may find it useful. This is James Bender for Waypoint Survival. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, make sure and check out the links in the description box below. And while you're down there, you'll also find our waypointsurvival.com link. This is where you can sign up to take great Waypoint Survival bushcraft and survival classes here at our property in Southern Ohio. And you can also leave us a comment in the comment section, and we'd really appreciate it. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. We'd really appreciate it. And if you do subscribe, make sure and press that bell button so that you can stay notified of all of our upcoming videos, and we'll talk to you next time.